Hello, so today I will be reviewing the recording functions on this TEAC AD-RW900 compact disc recorder slash reverse cassette deck. It also records to USB, from USB as well, to CDs and or tapes, and everything in between. So what we'll be doing, this is for sale on my eBay store, panthera.solutions.llc. So what we'll be doing first, I'll be recording from a cassette to a CD. So I've got two cassettes here. One is a Vivaldi concert and another is just a blank. I went ahead and verified that. I've also got a stack of blanks here, blank CDs. I've got a USB flash drive for demonstrating the flash drive recording function. And once we record from the tape to CD, I will go ahead and put it in the CD changer and verify that it has been recorded to. So let's get started by turning on the machine. We know that. Let's switch to CD first. Go to CD. Do make sure that you are using blank CDRs that specify they're for music. I've got into problems before where I tried regular CDRs, for example, Sony CDRs that say 700 megabytes on them, not the 80 minutes, but they did not say music. I also tried another type of CDs, TDK, which said 80 minutes and 700 megabytes. Both of them, it refused to record on. So do make sure that your CDRs do say explicitly music if you are going to be recording onto CDs. So just a tip for the future. All right. And it'll load it up and it will verify that it is a blank disc. While it's doing that, I'll go ahead and put in the cassette. That's the right side. Yeah, good. Okay, so it has verified that it is blank. And then we will switch to tape. So what we'll have to do is start playing the tape and then start recording. And then it says waiting. And record. Started recording. Very nice. All right, so let's let that record for a little bit. And just for demonstrations, I did not cue this up exactly as if I were to seriously record a tape to CD. I did not really cue it up. As you noticed, I had to push record twice. And yeah, so you would have to listen to the tape ahead of time and make sure that the lead-in on the tape, lead-in, I'm not sure what they call it. It's the part of the tape that's clear or doesn't have anything written on it. You have to make sure that when you push play, there's no music playing while you're hitting the record button. So you might have to be very quick with this. You can also do the same thing on the remote as well. I just haven't put any batteries in the remote, so yeah, that I will not be testing. But it is a remote, it works. So it's recorded about a minute. Let's go ahead and stop the recording. And now it's writing. Tape is stopped. Let's finalize the disc. Finalize. Oh, we gotta switch back to CD. There we go. Finalize. There we go. Do it. So maybe I have to push it more than once. So I guess you've got to push finalize and then the play pause button. That makes sense. But there's a bit of a learning curve to this. The manual is available, but I am doing this without the manual. As in, the manual is available online, but I haven't read it. So it's recording the table of contents. Once it's done burning, slash finalizing, whatever you want to call it. Seems like it should be done. Perfect. So let's see, it's not giving that option, so that means that it should run. And yes, it has been written to. That is fairly obvious. All right, so let's go ahead and open up the CD changer. Reads the table of contents correctly. There we go. You can see. Perfect. Okay, so you get the idea. It was successful. So there's that. Again, make sure to use CDR music discs. Not necessarily Maxell, just use any blank discs or blank media, whatever you'd like to call them, that are rated for music, sorry. So let's go ahead and record this same tape on a USB drive. And then we'll go ahead and verify that it recorded it by plugging it into my MacBook, and then, yeah. So then let's switch back to tape. We can put this in here. Oh, wait a second. Let me make sure that there's nothing on it. Real quickly. This video is going to pull for a while because I do not want to make any cuts into the video in order to show how authentically working this. Oh god, I can't speak today. Sorry about that. Okay. So that's good. So that's all blank. And let's switch back. We'll leave it where it is, 61. And we'll get back to that. So we'll go to USB. There's no USB in there. Now there is. And it'll say there's nothing on it. Switch back to tape. There we go. And then there's a tape in there. And then push play and click that. Okay. Now it. So then all you gotta do is push that again. And then it'll start recording. Time, and then we'll also try the same thing from a CD. This is a pressed CD, so no copies here. So we'll test a pressed CD recording onto the flash drive and recording onto the cassette deck. We'll go ahead and test that next. So that's pretty much good. We will stop the recording. I guess it made another track then. Okay, so let's say stop. Alright, so the recording has paused. That's fine. We'll stop the tape. I'm trying to. Here we go. Not exactly familiar with this machine's functions, so please bear with me. But yeah, we should be good actually. Let's just try to push stop. Oh, there we go. Okay, great. So then go to USB. Should find our file, or possibly two files. I'm not exactly sure how I recorded it. Yes, it's two files, but oh, went to the wrong input. Whatever, you get the idea. What I'll do is put this into the computer and we will see. Yes, see. So what this computer, this machine does, goes here, record, tape, and then it records it into MP3 files. Go ahead and open it up. I must say, on tape, it does record very well. So that worked perfectly, and this is the second file, which is like 5 seconds long. Perfect. So that worked. Alrighty then. So we'll go ahead and eject this. Oh, I wanted to delete the files first, so that we can do the same thing with the CD. So let's switch back to CD here. There. And then we'll test this disc, recording it to a flash drive first. Put that in there. Let me just make sure these files are gone. Move to trash. Perfect. Is reading the disk. Okay, it's read the disk. So now we'll go ahead and pull that out and we'll put the USB flash drive back in its place. Okay, and then we'll hit USB and then it has that there. It's preparing to record. Perfect. And then we can hit this and it'll start playing by itself. There we go. And so we'll let that record for a little bit. Okay, good enough. So we'll pause that. Oh, when you hit that button again, I guess it just makes another track. Oh, didn't do anything at this time. Okay, so we'll hit stop. Record ending, perfect. Then it stops the disc automatically. We'll switch back to USB. And it's reading the USB. So we'll go ahead and remove this. We'll go ahead and put it back in the machine. Open up the flash drive. And here's the MP3 of it. Great. Now we'll go ahead and get rid of this. I will go ahead and put a file on here. Let's put Hotshot on there. I believe this can read FLAC files. FLAC, whatever I like to say, FLAC. Eject. There we go. And let's put this in here and see what it says. If not, then I'll put an MP3 on there. Nope, that's not read FLAC. So we'll put an MP3 on there. Let's see, where do I have any MP3s? I'm sure I have one here somewhere. This is an MP3. Okay. Let's do this. Great. Good. All right, and now this should read. When you push play in this section, it switches automatically to the CD function. So make sure you use these buttons down here if you're using a flash drive. Alright, so let's go ahead and record from the flash drive to its blank. So, we will record. back to the flash drive. File, and then we'll record it to tape by pushing that. And now it's recording. You can see it moving, spinning in there. So we'll record a little bit of that. That's good enough for me to demonstrate. I do not have this hooked up, this machine, I don't have it hooked up to my home theater receiver right now, but you can see here that this will display that if music is playing. So we'll go ahead and stop the recording. So stop on the tape, and yeah, and we'll remove this. Nothing else in here. Where are you? CD here. Get rid of this too. There's nothing in the machine. Only our tape that we recorded. So then we'll go to switch to tape. One hit. Stop. Okay. And we should see this light up. There we go. Perfect. We'll go ahead and stop that. And oh. And then I also received a question about the to record from a record player to tape slash USB slash CD, whichever you choose. The only thing that you would have to do in order to do that is switch to whichever input that is on. If you're on phono, if you would have to switch to phono in phonograph. You can also record from optical audio. And you can also record from a line-in level input. So depending on what you're recording from, you have to switch to that input. This machine also has a phono preamp built in, so which is why there is a separate source for phonograph. So you just have to switch it to phono in, and you can also use this as just a preamp if your home theater receiver does not have a preamp, which mine doesn't in this case, so this would work out perfectly as well. If you have a record player that doesn't have a line level output. So yeah, so that has been the end of this very, very long video. Thank you very much for watching. Sorry I took up so much of your time, but that is just a demonstration of the functions and the condition of this TEAC AD-RW900. Thanks for watching, and it's for sale on my eBay store, panthera.solutions.llc. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Take care.